Hi guys, I hope you're all well. Goodness, it's been freezing this week, hasn't it? Hope you've kept cozy and warm, and it's good to see you again, and I hope you're all doing very, very well. Today I'm going to read you the story about baby Moses, which is a very famous Bible story, and I hope you enjoy it. Tiny baby Moses. Just skipping stones and chasing frogs along the River Nile. That's how two friends would spend their time, chattering all the while. For the Hebrew boy named Moses loved to hear the story of his dear friend's people and God's grace, a story filled with love. Now Moses came to know his friend in a most unusual way. That's how the story will begin, on that miracle of a day. Before the time of Moses' birth, a cruel Egyptian king made an unbelievable rule. His law changed everything. This king Pharaoh came to feel he should pay more attention. The Hebrew tribe was much too strong, too many to even mention. So Pharaoh chose to kill them all, each Hebrew baby son. But for the baby Moses, God's plan had just begun. For 3 months after he was born, his mother hid him well. His brother Aaron and sister Miriam had promised not to tell. Then God showed them his daring plan. Shield Moses from Pharaoh's might. Use a basket for a hiding place to keep him out of sight. They tucked him in a basket warm, and then they said goodbye. God planned to save this little one while watching them from on high. Miriam set the basket afloat, then hid right near the water. She spied some others coming close. One looked like Pharaoh's daughter. The princess and her servant girl heard a little cry. The servant girl took one quick look. A baby? A basket? Why? God placed these friends in Moses' life when he needed them the most. Protection came from God above, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. For though he was a Hebrew boy, the servant girl found out, the princess chose to spare his life, God's plan without a doubt. The princess let his mother care for Moses a while longer. Then in the palace he grew up, safer, wiser, stronger. Saved by the Father's lasting love, God would call this boy some day to lead his people and serve God, to follow and obey. God saves us too through his dear Son. From sin we have been freed. Like Moses, we are also called to serve, obey, and lead.
This wonderful story of Moses is a very good example of God having a plan for our lives. God had great plans for Moses, and he made sure that Moses was protected and kept safe in order to achieve these plans. If you believe in God and you trust in Jesus, he has great, great plans for your life too. And he will protect you and keep you safe in order for you to achieve those plans. Let us pray. Dear Lord, you had great plans for Moses, and you have great plans for our children too. Thank you for the gift of forgiveness that you gave us through your Son. And please lead us and direct us, your children, into lives of service for you. Amen. Have a wonderful week ahead, you guys.
Trust I will see his plan. future filled with hope. Jeremiah 29:11.